Hi loves, welcome back to another car chat video. So today I just want to do just a real quick video about something I was just thinking about, I think like last night or whatever, and that is, you know, a couple things about men now that I've really noticed that stood out to me, right? You know, it's a positive and it is also a negative. So I just wanted to share that in my opinion and what you might think, or if your observation has been, you know, similar to mine as far as how men are as of now. So one of the things I've noticed about men is that, is it me or it seems like the older that they become now, like the more immature they are. And I've been seeing this, not that I'm trying to notice or look for this sort of behavior or, you know, character flaw, but I've been seeing it quite regular for older men. I mean, like 40-ish, 50, they are doing a lot of immature-ish, saying immature things. Like, they're not coming off as men, like sexy. They're not giving sexy vibes anymore. And I find it to be a turnoff. I mean, this is like everywhere, like on social media, TV, like even in real life. And it's like the dialogue, it's like it's diminished from like a real wholesome conversation to just BS. And it's sad that it's coming from those who are older, like I said, in their 40s. Like you scroll down social media and you see a full-grown father, oversized man, well into his 40s, like dancing around and doing some crazy-ish that's not even funny. It comes off as goofy and corny. Like, you know, someone in the comments even said, look at this dancer. He looks like a dancing Eminem. It's just crazy. I don't care how much money you get. At some point, maturity has to seep in. Otherwise, you're just like a clown. Like, things that are being done. There's one guy just continuously troll this other man who's going through some serious allegations right now. He's just trolling the hell out of him. It's like, okay, we get it. You know, you have a vendetta against the dude. You have animosity. Okay, how much more petty can you get? It just shows signs of immaturity. I don't care how well established you are. It just doesn't look good. It's a turnoff. I was even watching the reality show Ready to Love. And the guys that came on there, immediately you look at them and you think, okay, maybe this is going to be a good batch this season. But no, more of the same, the verbiage. Like, how are you a twice divorcee with children and you still don't know how to converse on a first date? You know, it's one thing to ask someone about their sexual preferences. You know, the conversation has to lead that way at some point. And if you wanted to come a little sooner, that's okay. But when you start talking about, are you interested in threesomes, and, you know, two of the young ladies he's speaking to, and just like going deep, like deep into this conversation versus what are your goals in life? What are you trying to do as far, you know, relation, like going in that direction. This dude went in a completely different direction and it annoyed the hell out of me. Then you have another guy talking about yada, yada, yada. She said, okay, let's talk about something more in depth. He said, you want to go deep? And so he asks her, so what's your favorite movie? What type of movies do you like? He's like, I like thrillers. And she's just like, okay. Now, I did a video a couple videos back about, if you're not trying to entertain a situation, don't allow it to entertain you. And when he asks her that, her reply was, do you want another drink? I'm about to go and get me another mixed drink. You know, it was just so stupid. It's like, how are you also a divorcee with children and you still don't know how to have a meaningful dialogue? It's just crazy out here. And, you know, it's like, it's really changed. And I'm a girl's guy. I love the fellas. All of my friends, even since I was the age of 5, my first friend was a guy. So I know a lot about men and how they move. But I have never seen men at this level of immaturity, like their actions. I'm talking about the ones that are like Ray J. Like, they're just like a whole clown, an idiot. The only category you can put them in as being your homie. Like, okay, you one of the homies. I'll put you in that category. Like, you don't even make it to even being just a dating potential. And that's sad. You know, I had a lot of guy friends, and I still do, who are very mature. I mean, one night we were at one of my homeboy's birthday parties, and we were outside, me and another guy. One of his girls called him, and, you know, what we're going to do tonight, da-da-da. He said, well, right now I'm at my homeboy's birthday party. I will hit you up when I hit you up. Like, straight like that. No games, no stringing her along, you know, no shenanigans. It was just, like, real talk. Like, that's grown man-ish. And she's on the other line. Okay, da-da-da, I'm just calling it. Okay. You know, he's not giving her a bunch of smoke and mirrors. He's telling her straight up what it is. And you're not getting a lot of that today. Now, why is that? I can give you a laundry list of why that is, but I don't have that kind of time. I don't. It's just one of the things that I noticed. Men are gradually becoming more and more immature. And I know as I was coming up, they would say you always have to date a guy who's older than you because of the lack of immaturity. And I didn't do it intentionally, but it just kind of like helped, you know, went that way. And turns out it was right. I've always been way more mature than anybody, but they didn't give me goofiness, like just carelessness, just reckless energy. I didn't get that. Now it's just like across the board, you know, and it's quite depressing and sad when, if you are that type of person who's looking for something substantial while you're dating someone versus a bunch of clowns. But this is what you're getting, you know. So the other thing that I wanted to talk about is one that is more positive when it comes to guys, you know. So it's always been stated that men are the worst communicators. The memories are not the best, blah, blah, blah. Look, in case you haven't noticed, on many platforms and different outlets, men are very communicative. If they are not being a great communicator or communicating, you know, at an almost good state, there is a reason for that. All right. Allow me to reiterate, many of my friends are males. And most of them, if not all of them, have told me, I really enjoy talking to you. You listen, you're calm. So if you're a man, it's not coming to you with the energy of, I need you to listen to me, or I need some good feedback. I need someone who can just, you know, just whatever, just know how to communicate. If I have a concern, an issue that I'm going through, and I know you're going to be pissed off about it, you're going to come at me directly, like in a very serious, mature manner. Like, you're not going to give me a whole lot of lip and all of this stuff that I hear. And now you wonder why he doesn't tell you anything, because when he does, you pop off. I had a guy, a real good friend of mine. He, you know, he's married, and every time he speaks to me, man, I wish my wife could just listen and just talk like you do. And one day I asked him, like, so why did you marry her? I mean, it was a rhetorical question. We both know why, but why would you put yourself in a position of being with someone like forever, and you're going to have poor communication? She's not going to give you the feedback and the nurturing that you need. Now, mind you, he's a Pisces. Pisces communicate, and they need emotionally on a deeper level. So when they communicate, it can't be surface level or just something you just brush off. They need you to go deep. They need you to listen intently, that sort of thing. So he doesn't talk to her. And then she probably wonders why he doesn't confide in her. He'll call me, hit me up, or whatever. She understands that dynamic, but this is why. It's because there's a reason why your man is not confiding in you. He doesn't communicate. If you're hitting him up all the time, that's going to turn him off to wanting to say, oh, I'm thinking about Melinda. Let me just call her. You don't give him a chance to. So he doesn't bother anymore. My ex, one thing I can say about him, I like to give credit to where it's due. He was the best communicator, okay? I'm a busy person. And I might forget you a couple times out of the day, but I make up for it, you know? If I needed something, and I will call him on the first ring every single time he'd pick up, and I just never understood that. So I asked him one day, like, why do you always answer the phone on the first ring? He said, well, for one, it could be something urgent, and for two, I want to talk to you. You know, and I was like, oh, okay, I appreciate that, you know? But, see, he wants to, you know? Immediately, he's showing that he cares, and he wanted to talk to me. I never gave him a reason to not ever want to come and talk to me. I don't care how serious it is. You let that person in, and then you try to figure the ish out. When they made a big mistake, you're like, okay, all right, so how are we going to fix this versus just going off the hinges? He's going to cringe every time he needs to talk to you, and don't. So this is why it is important to learn who your partner is, who your guy is, and how he communicates. Because trust and believe, when I tell you men are excellent communicators, they really are. I have been in many group settings with just all guys. And the conversations, the topics, and for how long they can extend into. Oh, by the way, they are like the best gossipers. In case you don't know that. Have you seen the platforms? Like Math Hoffa? Yes, these guys can talk. They're very well good communicators. So if your person is not talking to you, they're talking to someone else. It could be their homeboys, whomever. Someone who's going to listen and give them that kind of feedback or wisdom that they need. And this is why a lot of relationships are failing, because a man simply cannot open up and go deeper, especially when he really is into his feels and he needs to. And so if they're not doing that with you, well, this is why. It's not like they're a bad communicator, just don't want to communicate with you in particular. All right, so I just wanted to show those two things that I've really, that has really stood out to me over the past, you know, I'll say year or so with the guys. All right. So let me know your thoughts, your experiences, what you think about men being immature and being more talkative now, more expressive, you know, that sort of thing, which isn't bad, because I always want to know what's on the mind of an individual. All right. And you may be wondering, why do you like guys so much? Well, I tend to find them to be a bit more interesting and loyal, if you were wondering. All right. So I'm going to leave that right here for now, my guys. I thank you for joining me always. Until next time.